श्री गुरुवे नमः स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन टीचिंग एकेडमी एकलैवा। इन द प्रीवियस सेशंस वी हैव सीन हाउ द पावर इज बीइंग शेयर्ड बिटवीन द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ द पावर इज बीइंग शेयर्ड विद द लोकल गवर्नमेंट, दैट इज द थर्ड टीयर ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट। So you will know the meaning of decentralization and the features of decentralization, how the working of rural government is taking place. Up to that we are going to see in this session. What is decentralization? When power is taken from central and state governments and given to local government, it is called decentralization. So why the third tier of government? A vast country like India cannot be run only through two tiers of government, that is the central government and the state government. So the federal power sharing in India needs another tier of government below that of the state government. So this is the rationale for decentralization of power that resulted in the third tier of government, that is called local government. So what is the basic idea behind decentralization? There are a large number of problems and issues which are best settled at the local level. For example, let us assume that near our school in VM Nagar, the roads are in poor condition and it's very difficult to reach the school because of the bad condition of the roads. So immediately that ward councillor, a member, will be approached by the people residing in that area to inform the condition of the roads, and being the local person, being the person of that locality, he knows better than anybody else. So immediately he will take steps to alter the roads, to change the roads from the poor condition to a better condition. So the problems of that particular locality will be best settled in the local level. That's the idea of the third tier of government, that is decentralization. So besides that, at the local level it is possible for the people to directly participate in decision making. That's the crux of democracy. So this helps to inculcate a habit of democratic participation. People's participation is very, very important in a democratic country. So there are a large number of problems and issues best settled at the local level. That's the main reason, basic idea behind decentralization. Let's see how it works. The constitution was amended in the year 1992 to make the third tier of democracy more powerful and effective. Why in the year 1992 the constitution was amended? It's because the need for decentralization was recognized in our constitution. But there have been several attempts to decentralize power to the level of villages and towns. panchayats in the villages and municipalities in the urban areas were set up in all the states. But these were directly under the control of state governments. Elections to these local governments were not held regularly. That was a trouble. And the local governments did not have any powers of their own, and resources also they didn't have. So there was very little decentralization in effective terms before 1992. So as it was observed, and the constitution was amended towards decentralization, so that the third tier of democracy became more powerful and effective. So what were the measures taken? The first one, to hold regular elections for the local government bodies, like general elections and the state assembly elections. Every 5 years, local government body elections are taking place. Seats reserved for scheduled castes and scheduled tribes and other backward classes. So that was also ensured, so that the people, those who didn't get an opportunity to compete in the election, they get an opportunity. And reserved constituencies have been allotted for SCs and STs to be on par with other people. Now, 33% reservation for women did not take place in the legislative assembly elections and general elections, but it has been successfully implemented by the constitution through this 1992 amendment. 1/3 seats have to be reserved for women. That was the best feature of this amendment. So at least 1/3 of all positions are reserved for women. That's the best feature. Apart from that, an independent institution, that is the State Election Commission, had been created in each state to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. State Election Commission was created in every state. So the state governments are required to share some powers and revenue, both powers and revenue, with the local government bodies. But the nature of sharing of power and revenue varies from state to state. So let's get into the rural local government. How does that work in our country? That is the Panchayati Raj, rural local government. So this is the mind map for rural local government. So local self-government is a self-government that has been divided into rural local self-government and urban local self-governments. So in towns, it is known as municipalities, and the municipal chairperson is the head. And big cities, it is known as municipal corporation, and mayor is the head. So with that, we'll get an idea how it is known in town and big cities, municipalities and municipal corporations. So this is the mind map for the Panchayati Raj, otherwise known as rural local government. So at the village level, it is known as Grama Panchayat, and it is formed by Gram Sabha, and the head is known as Sarpanch or the president. The ward members are called as, the council consisting of several ward members are often called as Panch. The next level is block. Block is otherwise known as Panchayat Samiti or Mandal. It is also known by the name of Mandal. So the Panchayat Samiti members are elected by the Panchayat, Gram Panchayat members. and the head is the BDO, Block Development Officers. For the topmost tier in this is district level, which is also known as Zilla Parishad. The members are formed by the by election, formed by elected members, and have members of Lok Sabha and MLA of the district because it is district level. Every district has a Zilla Parishad, and Zilla chairperson is the head. So let us understand how this works out. Rural local government. Now, rural local government is popularly known as Panchayat Raj. Each village or a group of villages in some states has a Gram Panchayat. So Gram Panchayat is the least level. And in Gram Panchayat, a village or a group of villages are there. So it is a council. Gram Panchayat is a council consisting of several ward members are elected through elections, often called a panch and a president or sarpanch. They are directly elected by all the adult population in, living in that ward. So through elections, the ward members are elected and they are known as panch, and the head is known as the president or sarpanch. So panchayat, how that works out? It is the decision making body for the entire village. So the panchayat works under the overall supervision of the Gram Sabha. All the voters in the village are its members. It has to meet at least twice or thrice in a year to approve the annual budget and review the performance of the Gram Panchayat. So the Gram Panchayat work will be reviewed every twice or thrice when they meet. Okay, how they perform the from the previous session, previous meeting to the next meeting will be reviewed. So thrice or twice they meet in a year. So let's go to the last one, that is the last, the topmost tier, the first tier. The Gram Panchayat are grouped together to form what is usually called a Panchayat Samiti or block or mandal. The members of this representative body are elected by all the Panchayat members in that area. All the Panchayat Samitis are mandals in a district together constitute the Zilla Parishad. Zilla Parishad chairperson is the political head of the Zilla Parishad. Now, let me explain this. Now, let us understand, here is a district, Nilgiris. Let us take this. This state is divided into blocks. Every block is divided into Gram Panchayat. So, the block or samiti or mandal in a district together form a Zilla. Zilla is the first tier, second tier is Panchayat Samitis, third tier is Gram Panchayat. So let me explain in detail about this with the help of this diagram. So Zilla Parishad is the topmost tier. It is district. So the district is divided into various blocks, you can see that. So all these blocks put together known as one district. So let's come to the next level. The Panchayat Samiti or block or mandal. So the Gram Panchayat, various Gram Panchayats together form a mandal or a block or Panchayat Samiti. So this Panchayat Samiti block is forming the next level, that is district. Let us come to the least here, that is in the local government, Gram Panchayat. A village, it might be one village or a group of villages. from gram panchayat. So the gram panchayat, one gram panchayat, one village or many villages can be there, a group of villages can be there. So that goes to many gram panchayats. Those gram panchayats are known as panchayat samiti, block or mandal. Those block or mandal forms a district. This is how it functions. I hope you would have understood in a better manner. So by this way, it is being, the work is taking place in the local government, in Panchayati Raj. Let's go to the second form of local government, that is in urban. So far what we have seen is rural. Now in this you can see, local government bodies exist in urban areas also. So it is divided again, divided into towns and big cities. It is divided into two. So municipalities are set up in towns. And a municipal chairperson is the head. And in big cities, municipal corporations are set up. Corporations, Chennai, Coimbatore, Madurai, Tiruchi, all these big cities have corporations. For that, for those corporations, mayor is the head. So both are controlled by elected bodies consisting of people representatives who are selecting these municipal ward members or the corporation ward members. Of course, they are chosen by the people living in that respective area. So, I hope you would have understood the rural local government, that is Panchayati Raj, in a better manner. Thank you, children. We'll meet in the next history lesson.